Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing well. Today we'll start with chapter number 11, kinds of sentences. So what is a sentence? A group of words that makes complete sense is called a sentence. As you can see, the three examples given up here under the banyan tree. When he entered the house, he found his dog sitting under the banyan tree. So among these three sentences, which one is the only sentence which stands as complete, meaningful, senseful, and even correct in terms of writing? Not only in terms of speaking or listening, but in terms of writing also, which sentence makes a complete sense, which is meaningful? Yes, it's the third one. Okay, under the banyan tree. So what is under the banyan tree? You cannot predict what this sentence is talking about, or when he entered the house, what after that. Okay, but in the third sentence we can understand that when he entered the house, the dog was sitting under the banyan tree. Okay, this sentence stands as meaningful. So that is why a sentence is a group of words that makes complete sense, those which are meaningful. Okay, there are few points how you can make a sentence meaningful. So while arranging the words in a proper order to make it meaningful, the first letter of the sentence, the first word, first letter of the sentence should be capital. Second, has words placed in proper order, which I told you just a few minutes back, that the words should be arranged in a proper manner. For example, over here you can see color blue, favorite is mine. So is it making any sense? No. Why? Because they are not arranged in a proper order. So if you want to arrange it in the proper order and make it meaningful, it would be as, my favorite color is blue. Now, being properly arranged, the sentence stands as meaningful. Now the sentence makes a complete sense. Next point is, ends with a full stop, a question mark, or an exclamation mark. Each and every sentence ends with a punctuation. Which punctuations? There are three punctuations with the help of which the sentence can end. It's a full stop, exclamation mark, and a question mark. Okay. Then only in this case, the sentence would stand as meaningful and correct in terms of speaking, in terms of writing. Okay. So over here you can see in the first exercise, what you have to do is you have to rearrange the following words and phrases to form meaningful sentences. So all the words are jumbled over here. You have to arrange them in a proper order to make it meaningful. See, the first one has been done for you. Was a about 50 childhood wonderful time years ago. So it has been arranged as, childhood was a wonderful time about 50 years ago. Okay, so this is the sentence making complete sense, which is meaningful. Let us take the second one. Spent almost most children playing and studying equal time as they did. Now, how you will arrange this sentence in a proper order? First would be, most children spent almost equal time playing as they did in studying. Okay, so the sentence becomes as, most children spent almost equal time playing as they did in studying. Okay, so now the sentence is making complete sense. This is how you have to do this exercise. So rest remaining three is to be done by you. Now, coming to kinds of sentences. This you have read earlier in your previous classes also. There are four kinds of sentences. Assertive or declarative. Then you have imperative. Then you have imperative sentences. Then you have interrogative sentences. And the last is exclamatory sentences or interjections. Okay. Coming to the first one, assertive or declarative, this is a simple statement which gives us information. Okay, a sentence which gives us information, which is just a simple sentence. Okay, see over here what it is written. An assertive sentence is a sentence that states a fact. Such sentences are simple statements. They state, assert or declare something. Okay, see for example, Mohit is a student. He lives in a big city. So this is just a simple statement in a form of an information. It is just a the sentence is giving us some information. And this kind of sentences, assertive sentences, ends with a full stop. Okay. Next, over here you can see an affirmative sentence makes a statement. Okay, this one. And the next point is, a negative sentence is one in which there is no, not or never. Means you can say assertive ke do parts hain. First is affirmative sentence which makes a statement. For example, Hari is a tall boy. Okay. And the second type is negative sentence in which you can find the word, negative words like no, not or never. So Naveen is not tall boy. So this sentence would be known as negative sentence. Affirmative sentence, or you can say in a way that it is a positive statement. In the negative statement, it is where you will have the negative words like no, not and never. Now, a sentence that has negative meaning but does not have no, not or never, it cannot be called a negative sentence. Okay. इतना हमें मालूम है कि अगर negative sentence में किसी sentence में हमारे पास no, not या never होता है, then in that case it would be known as negative sentence. Okay. But अगर हमारे सेंटेंस में नो नॉट नेवर नहीं है लेकिन उसका मीनिंग नेगेटिव निकल रहा है तो वो नेगेटिव सेंटेंस नहीं कहलाएगा. ओके, हमें मीनिंग इसमें इस सेंटेंस में हमें मीनिंग पे ना जाते हुए इसके फॉर्मेशन ऑफ सेंटेंसेस पे हमको फोकस करना है. ओके, सी फॉर एग्जांपल ओवर हियर, आई एम नॉट हैप्पी. सो दिस इज अ नेगेटिव सेंटेंस बिकॉज द प्रेजेंस ऑफ वर्ड नॉट इज हियर. ओके, इन द सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल आई एम अनहैप्पी, ये भी एक साउंड करता है नेगेटिव सेंटेंस जैसा. ओके, बट डोंट गेट कंफ्यूज, दिस इज एन एफर्मेटिव सेंटेंस. ये एक एफर्मेटिव सेंटेंस, एक पॉजिटिव सेंटेंस है. इवन दो द मीनिंग इज सेम, जब भी इसका एक्चुअली मीनिंग भी वही है, आई एम नॉट हैप्पी. ठीक है, आई एम अनहैप्पी मीन्स आई एम नॉट हैप्पी. Meaning is same, but there is no negative word like no, not or never. So it would stand as affirmative sentence. Okay? Now come to imperative sentence. Imperative sentence, a command, order or a request you can say, or a wish you can say. Okay? Any sentence which is which gives you an order, which gives you a command, which requests, which gives the meaning of a wish. See what is written over here. An imperative sentence is a sentence which gives command, makes request or expresses a wish. Okay? See the examples. Go to your room, an order. Please lend me your book, a request. Have a good time at the picnic, a wish. Coming to interrogative sentences. Interrogative, the word interrogative itself says question. The sentences which are in a form of a question, and the punctuation used over here is question mark at the end of the sentence. So an interrogative sentence is a sentence that asks question. For example, what is your name? Where do you live? What are you doing? What are you eating? When will you come back? So all the sentences which are in a form of a question are interrogative sentences. Now come to exclamatory sentences. Exclamatory sentence means wherein in the sentence you can express your feelings, your feelings related to happiness, sorrow, sad. Okay, see what is written over here. An explanatory sentence is a sentence that expresses sudden and strong feelings such as surprise, wonder, pity, sympathy, happiness or gratitude. Okay, see for example, what is shame? Boy, am I tired? Okay, so the sentences ending with exclamation mark are known as exclamatory sentences. Okay, sentence means what? The combination in the group of words. But what are interjections? Over here you can see, what are interjections then? What are interjections? Interjections are actually the single small words, a single word. Or you can say interjections are short words or utterances which show strong feeling or emotions. Okay, so strong feeling or emotion show karta hai aur wo apna ek single word hota hai. Okay, see, they are spoken when a person is very surprised, happy or upset. Interjections are not always complete sentence. Interjections do not stand as meaningful alone. Okay, sentences, sometimes they are more like a noise than a word. They are sounding words. Okay, for example, see the sentences over here. Hurrah, we won the competition. So hurrah is your interjection. Ouch, it hurts. Interjection. Wow, what a nice shirt. Wow is interjection. Hey, alas, oh. Okay, so these are the words which are known as interjections, and the group of words forming the expression giving the strong feelings are known as exclamatory sentence. And remember, exclamatory sentences or interjections ends with an exclamation mark. Now come to the second exercise. Fill in the blanks with suitable interjections selected from the words in the bracket. Okay, let's take the first one. Dash, silence in the library. So hush. Okay, you should know the meaning of these interjections. Alas is used for sadness and hush is used to make someone quiet. Okay, take the next one. You won the poetry competition. So dear me, no, it's bravo. Bravo means appreciating someone. Dear me, showing some kind of a sympathy to someone. Okay, so bravo, you won the poetry competition. So in this way, try to solve all the next three. Okay, now coming to different kinds of sentence make reading and writing more interesting to help a better understanding of using the different kinds of sentences. Read the following paragraph. See, my favorite type of food is pizza. I just love tomato and double cheese pizza. I could eat pizzas morning, noon and night. I think I shall order a pizza right now. Now read the next paragraph. What is your favorite type of food? Mine is pizza. I just love tomato and double cheese pizza. I never get tired of it. Sometimes I think I could eat pizzas morning, noon and night. All this talk of pizza is making me hungry. Let us order a pizza now. So over here, what is the difference between of the first paragraph and the second paragraph? What kinds of sentences did we use in the second paragraph? we have, we used assertive, we used, do we have exclamatory? Yes, we have exclamatory sentence, we have interrogative sentence. Okay, so we have used all these combination of sentences to make reading more interesting, to make reading more interactive. Okay, so that is why it is very important to use all these kinds of sentences while you are writing something. So over here now in the third exercise, you can see given below is a paragraph. It contains some information. Make this paragraph interesting by writing, rewriting it using the different kinds of sentences as shown above. So in this, what you have to do is, this is to be done by you. This paragraph has been given as just a simple information, but you have to make it more interesting, just we had in the example. Jaise ki humne yahan pe dekha tha ki how this paragraph changed into this paragraph and the paragraph became very interesting. So you have to do the same in this exercise also. This is completely your homework. This is to be done by you. Okay? Now, see, earlier we had learnt about different kinds of sentences: assertive, interrogative, imperative, and exclamatory. We differentiated between these sentences based on what each of them did. The assertive sentence makes a statement, the interrogative asks questions, imperative issues a command or request, and the exclamatory sentence expresses a strong emotion or feeling. Another way to classify sentences is to differentiate between them based on the number of clauses they contain. Okay, so in order to do that, let us first briefly revise what finite and non-finite verbs are.